Hey everyone, welcome back. Let's build our x-axis. Again, we can start by preparing our linear rails. Make sure you have wiped them down to clean all of the oil off first. Then we will need 17 14mm M4 screws and 17 M4 sliding T-nuts for each rail. Insert your M4 screws and turn the M4 sliding T-nuts one turn on the backside. Once you have completed both linear rails, slide the two rails into the C-beam extrusion. This will be 1000mm or 1500mm depending on your machine size. Once these are both on, go ahead and tighten down one rail, letting the rail center itself using the T-nuts. On the second rail, only tighten down the end T-nuts just to hold it from falling off. We will tighten these down later. With our four pre-cleaned HDR bearings, slide each on, letting the cover fall only as the rail takes its position. Again, if you're using grease nipples on yours, make sure they are facing away from each other so that you'll be able to access them later. Place two on each rail and then we can set this C-beam aside. Onto building our X gantry plate now. We will need one plate, two spacer blocks with two 8mm nut blocks and four M5 45mm screws with four Nyloc nuts. Sliding two screws in the side holes of the plate, place the spacer block in between them, then slide the 8mm nut block. Lastly, the Nyloc nuts. When screwing the Nyloc nut down, make sure that it tightens inside the recess. Screw this all the way down and then back it off half a turn. Now you can go ahead and repeat the exact same steps on the other side of the plate. The X gantry plate can now be installed onto the X C-beam. You will need the X-axis C-beam that we just made, as well as the X plate we just built. Lastly, you will need 16 M4 12mm button head screws. Start by placing it onto the C-beam, then slide the bearings underneath it. This allows the nut block to clear the bearing blocks. Now screw all of the M4 screws in a few turns. Once they are all threaded, proceed to tighten them all down. Similar to what we did on the y-axis, you should move the plate along the rails, tightening the rail screws that we left loose nearest to the plate first. There should be no binding once this is done. Now it's time to install the XC beam onto the machine. I like to place the rail onto the machine and use something like a long screwdriver through a hole in the plate to support the C beam while I work on the other end. Once you have this supported, you're going to need 8 M5T nuts. We do this now to make sure that we don't drop any during the positioning. Place 2 in each slot on the top and 2 in each slot on the bottom. Now align your plate and thread each of your 6 M5 20mm low profile screws into the C beam. When they are all threaded, proceed to tighten them down. Once you're done one side, remove your supporting screwdriver and repeat the same process on the other side. Now take your 20x40 extrusion and place it onto the back side of the C-beam. Slide 2 T-nuts into the top and bottom of the extrusion. With 4 M5 20mm low profile screws, secure the extrusion to the Y-plates. Now we're going to add the 90 degree corner brackets to the C beam and the 20x40 extrusions using 6 90 degree brackets and 12 M5 8mm low profile screws. Start by threading the brackets into the Y plates and tightening. Then align one of the T nuts we already slid into the 20x40 extrusion and tighten to that. Repeat this for 3 across the top and 3 across the bottom, and then again repeat this process for the other side of the rail. And that's it for the X-axis. Thanks for sticking around and stay tuned for the next video in which we will build a Z-axis.